Hello, I'm Nelson with GS Sporting Goods. We have here the new 2011 Pinarello KOBH. The KOBH is a project of a joint venture between Pinarello and the Sky Professional Cycling Team in developing a bike specifically for the Northern Classics, such as paris-roubaix, that are notorious for having extremely bad roads. One of the things they found with the KOBH is it's an excellent bike for Grand Mondo riders, century riders, people who like to do longer distances, want to get a little bit of extra comfort on there. Ride on rough roads, need a little bit larger tire. Very good bike for that. The KOBH is actually a derivative of the Dogma. It's the same grade of carbon. It shares the same asymmetry of the Dogma. The top tube stays fork. Same 60-ton carbon, 60 HM 1.K carbon. Shares a nano-alloy technology and carbon layup to prevent small micro-fractures from coming to larger problems. That's the same EPS, expanded polystyrene mold that's used for laying up the carbon. Gives you an extremely clean inside of the tubes, very smooth. Makes for a very quiet ride, very, very smooth ride. The main differences between the KOBH and the Dogma, of course, the obvious one is that they don't have the Honda seat stay system. The rear system on this frame, which they call Century Ride, is designed primarily to get more clearance for a larger tire, but also to soften the ride. It gives a lot more vertical compliance without giving up any of the lateral stability that you're used to with the Dogma, or to lose any efficiency in the pedal. It's also got a little bit longer chain stays, longer seat stays. Same with the fork. The fork got a little bit more range to it, a little bit longer crown to drop out the crown ratio. What this does is allow you to have a bigger tire. Also allows you to have a little bit more damping, a little more comfort to the ride, more vertical compliance. Wheelbase is slightly longer, geometry is slightly slacker. In most sizes, it's about a degree slacker in the seat tube, and ranges from about a half degree to a degree and a half in the head tube. The handlebar will tend to be a little bit higher on the KOBH simply because the fork is longer. Head tube's going to be about the same length, but you're going to be 4 or 5 millimeters usually higher front end, which for rough conditions can be very good. Very similar ride characteristics. Of course, the Dogma was the first bike manufactured with a completely asymmetrical frame. Left side of the frame is totally different from the right in the shape. It used a lot of shaping carbon to counteract forces that are caused by the drivetrain being off center. Some of the key points in that, of course, are the chain stays on the left-hand side are larger toward the bottom bracket, on the right-hand side more toward the dropouts. The right fork blade is going to be a little bit thicker than the left one. The top tube is going to be a little different on the left side than the right side. Goes throughout the frame, it's all done, figured with computer modeling, exactly where the stresses were the strongest, where they needed to reinforce areas, and where they could reduce weight by removing some of the carbon. As I said, the KOBH was developed largely in conjunction with the Sky Professional Team. This is the actual bike that they would be riding. It's available as a frame set from GDA. It comes either set up for conventional drivetrains, or like this one for Shimano's DI2, which will also be usable for the camping electronic Grubo when it comes out. It comes internally wired. This would be the exact bike that Sky Team is using in the classics.